Beijing Opera is the largest Chinese opera. It recognized as the national quintessence of China, and extolled as oriental opera in the Western world. Comparing with other traditional Chinese opera, although Beijing Opera only has two-century history, it has absorbed the essential of Chinese opera and created its own style. Beijing Opera's stage property is very simple, and its stage is almost bare, which means the expression of the story mostly depends on the character's performance. It might be because Beijing Opera is originally performed in the tea house. In order to attract more audience, they need to set the stage and begin the performance very quickly. On the contrary, the characters are more complex. It's divided into four kinds: Shen, Dan, Jing, Chou. Shen is the male character. Dan is a female character. This character is really interesting because before 1970s, all of the Dan characters are performed by the male. During Republic period of China, the most famous performers are the four famous Dan, include Mei Lanfang, Shang Xiaoyun, Chen Yanqiu, and Xu Huishen. Their appearance and act of the female character are just like the true woman. Jing often refers to male character with unique appearance and personality. The facial painting Lianpu is mostly designed for this character. It is a colorful dressing on actor's face, and the audience would easily to learn their temperament from the color of Lianpu. For example, red symbolizes loyalty and white represents cunning. Chou is a comic role. The actor's face is painted by a piece of white powder, making him or her easily recognizable. The performance used singing, dialogue, dancing, and martial art as the main method to represent dramatic play and figure on the stage. If it is your first time to watch Beijing Opera, the martial art might be more attractive.
I love the performance of Beijing Opera, like they use water sleeves to emphasize mood, and the most interesting thing I think is the expression of the story. For example, the character would show running down mountains by turning some sort of sketch tables.
I think one of the unique parts of the Beijing Opera might be that they invite male to perform female. Just like the famous actor Mei Lanfang, it's difficult to recognize that he's a male when he performs female in the opera.
What's your opinion about the interesting parts of Beijing Opera? Please leave a comment below. And if you like this video, please click a like and subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching.